Hey, I'm Dirk from Airgunseurope.com, and today we're going to look at the FX Dreamline, mainly the regulator and how to adjust it. The thing is, there is a lot of information about how to do this, of course. The thing is, I've been multiple generations of this rifle right now. There's also been old information, old tutorials. If you have those older rifles, of course, those will still be viable. But for the newer generations, these have been around for, well, years right now. So this will be a little bit more updated. Also, there's a lot of other information and other questions that we get about the regulator. So I just want to show you how I do it and why I do it this way. This will work for the Dreamline Classic. So this version, this is the walnut version. Synthetic will of course also work. And it will also work for the light and the tactical if you have the normal tube underneath. If you have, for example, the bottle or the compact, in those cases, the regulator adjustment is slightly different. You can probably still follow along, but the degassing will be different. So yeah, let's get started. All right. So here we have the rifle out of the stock. I've took the rifle out of the stock because it's a lot easier to work on like this, and it's a nice opportunity to check if the rifle is okay below the stock line. So there's no dirt or grime here, and if your trigger group is okay, check for rust or anything, of course. Also a reason is that the regulator adjustment screw, in my case, is below the stop line. In your case, it could be here, it could be here, on the left, on the bottom. If you're really unfortunate, it could be below the barrel, and you actually need to remove the barrel to change it. That's of course unfortunate, but that's the way it is with these rifles. It's because the threading on the inside of this part, the regulator housing plenum piece, the threading on the inside to attach it to the rifle is actually threaded without looking how these holes are aligned. Because of this, it's of course easy to manufacture it like that, and it's a lot cheaper to manufacture it like that. It takes less time. Now, as I mentioned in the intro, there is another way of doing this. This is my way. The way it's used to be written in the manual. I think it still is, but I haven't checked. But you can still find these a lot on the internet, is that when you lower the pressure, you just shoot a couple of times. You don't need to degas the rifle. I don't like doing that because of the way how this regulator works. And I will quickly show you. So just to visualize it a little bit. This is on the inside of your regulator. This is the regulator adjustment screw. And this is your regulator piston. The piston actually has a black piece of Delrin or some other kind of sealing material. And on the bottom of the adjustment screw, there's a small hole. Let's see if we can get it to focus a bit better. Good enough. There's a hole here, you have to believe me. And when the regulator has reached the desired pressure, they touch and they seal. And now the plenum has the desired pressure for every single time they open and close. There's a couple of spring washers on this piece, but yeah, just to visualize, when you shoot, this one goes back, and until the pressure has been reached, they touch, and then they close. Now, when you adjust this screw, this is the same one as here on the outside, when you go up in pressure, you turn it outwards, you pull it back, and then the piston, when you pull it back, the piston will follow. That's no problem, it's completely fine. Now, when you turn it in, so you go clockwise, you close it, yeah, actually the sharp edges of the hole will actually be cutting into the seal. And now in theory, if you just shoot and in the meantime when they're not touching, then in theory you could quickly give it a quick turn, but you will always probably be touching it. And I've had a lot of repairs because of this. I had to replace a lot of these. Now, I just recommend degassing the entire rifle when you do this, because then when you close it, this one will be back here. And there's not really a big issue. So that's how the regulator works and why I like doing it this way. There's probably a couple of other ways you could do it, but this is my way and I like it doing it this way. And I've never had any issues doing it this way. Also a big interesting part about this one is if you have the older version, you need to degas the rifle by unscrewing both gauges. Now in this case, we have a degassing screw, so that's a lot easier. Now, to start the tutorial, we first want to raise the pressure because that's really easy. Currently we're at 100 bar, and let's say we want to go to 120, just for tutorial sake. So we grab our key. insert it. And when we want to raise the pressure, we want to turn the screw out. Now, it's a normal screw, so lefty-loosey. Now, we can see the needle going to the right. And when we're getting close, I like to shoot a couple of times to make sure that the regulator is open and closing in a natural way, just like when you're shooting. Now you can see it's going a little bit to the left. That's why we shoot a couple of times. Go back up. Oh. And there we go, about 120. So now let's say we've done our testing, we've been shooting, and this is not really the speed we want to have or our pressure we want to use for our kind of ammunition. So we want to lower it back down. Now, what we do, we should never turn it in, because as I just mentioned, you will damage your regulator piston. So first we will degas the rifle. For this, insert a key, insert a good quality one, because else you will damage the screw. And just loosen it. Don't unscrew it, but loosen it. Maybe like half or two thirds of a turn. Something like that. And it will start bleeding air. This will take a while. Don't try to rush it. Don't unscrew it. You will launch it through the room, maybe into your eyes. Don't do that. Always wear safety goggles doing this, because there's a lot of pressure behind this. And it's just a couple of threads holding on to it. So now when this is bleeding, put it down, don't try to rush this, just walk away and make some coffee or what else. So I'll see you guys in a few. Now, as you probably noticed, the gauge isn't moving. That's because the air is bleeding from the tube into the regulator, filling the plenum, and then from the plenum it's bleeding out. Because of this, the pressure in here is pretty constant, because the regulator is doing its job. So when you loosen this one, it will back off a little bit and then stay the pressure until this pressure actually drops below the regulator pressure, and then it will start bleeding down. So it's empty and now we can continue. So what we now do is we insert our key again and we will close it down and keep your fingers on the side so you can feel the earliest resistance. Now that you feel resistance, immediately stop, take your hands off, and back off quarter of a turn. Quarter, half, whatever. Just back it off. So now when we fill the rifle again, the regulator can still move. It will seal at a really low pressure, and then we can raise the pressure back up until we have a desired pressure again. So always when you set the regulator, you always do it under pressure, because else you don't know what you're doing. So let's fill this rifle back up. After we've tightened this one, of course. All right, we're back, and we currently have a pressure of 50 bars inside of the plenum. The tube is at 170, so we currently have enough space or enough pressure to move back to the 100 bar. Always make sure there's enough air in here. If you're going really high, do have a bottle on standby. So we insert our key again. Zoom in a little bit. And now if I turn it to the left, so we're going back out again. So we raise the pressure back up. Lefty loosey. So now we're getting close, so we shoot a couple of times. So and then back at 100, just a little bit more. Perfect. So of course, if you're really going down to the single bar, Then of course you do need a digital gauge to make sure you're always going to the same pressure. But other than that, you're probably completely fine using it this way. Well, as I mentioned, this is quite an easy rifle to work on, but you do need to know these little things in order not to damage the parts. If you have any questions, do reach out to us. You can always send us an email or give us a call. Well, if you have any questions or suggestions about other air guns or this air gun, video suggestions, do leave them in the comments, and maybe in the future you will see a new video. Well, thank you for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.